Hey guys, this is Mark. In this video, I will demonstrate the process of migrating a UI application created with UI Builder out of Backendless so you can run it off of any web host that provides web hosting functionality. The process is quite straightforward. It consists of just a few steps, and let's just dig in. So the first thing to understand is that when you create a UI Builder application, the logical unit that you work with is called UI container. And you can see the containers that you have by moving the mouse pointer over here. And in containers, I have quite a few. It will show you the currently selected container. And for most applications, you will have just one or two. You may have multiple, but keep in mind that UI container is the actual UI Builder application. So you could have multiple UI Builder applications. Each would be its own container that has its own pages. So whenever you have a UI container, it will contain one or more pages, the style sheets, CSS, all the logic, everything goes into that UI container. Here I have just one page that communicates with the database and brings data. So let me run this page so you can see what happens. It will just render a data table with some data. So we know that there is a very primitive UI that fetches data from Backendless. So here, let's say that the goal is to take this UI container, everything that it contains, and move it outside of Backendless so it runs somewhere else on a web host. So the step number one will be to publish this container. And what happens here is, well, you will need to click this icon right here in this green publish block. Click it here, and then you'll need to select a directory where that container is going to be published to. And what happens here is Backendless will do a lot of work to compress and package your UI application and deploy it to that specific directory. It can be any directory under either sitting in the actual slash web or a subdirectory under web. And you can click add folder and then create a new directory where the container is going to be published to. So here I have this directory called my app that I created just for the demonstration purposes. So now I click publish, and it will take a little bit of time to package it together and get it published. Really depends on how big your application is. It will take longer or it sometimes could be rather quick. So at this point, it reported that the application has been published. So at this point, everything has been pre-packaged and sits in Backendless. So now if we go to Backend and then navigate to files, you'll need to locate that directory. I have quite a few directories, in fact. What I can do is I'll usually disable search in subdirectories and search for web. It will find, actually, I'm already in web. That's why there were not a lot of directories. But let's say if you are in the root, deselect search in directories, type in web. It will locate that web directory, go in there. And in here, you will find your directory. And here is mine, my app. So navigate to that directory, and this is everything that UI Builder and Backendless created that is now packaged in that directory. So what you want to do is all of this content needs to be migrated elsewhere to another web host. And the simplest process to do this is to click this zip directory link. Zip directory always works in the context of the directory that you are in. So now I am in the slash web slash my app, and zip directory will zip everything recursively that is located in the my app directory. So click zip directory, and it starts this process. Once again, depending on the size of your application, it could be either very quick or take a little bit of time. And then keep in mind that the created zip file will be located one level up, which means that it will be placed in the web directory here. So go into web, and in here, if we refresh, actually what I can do is I'm gonna search for myapp.zip. And there you go. So here's my app.zip. It has been created. And at this point, what I can do is just download this file. Okay, so here, downloading. And now I have the zip file that contains the entire UI Builder application sitting on my local hard drive. So now what I will do is I will go to the file storage, and then I will just unzip this directory. Okay. And this is everything that was placed in there. The reason I unzipped it is because the web host that I picked to demonstrate this functionality works by uploading like all of the files individually. I can do drag and drop for all of them, which is what I will do. Some web hosts may provide the functionality of uploading a zip and just extracting it right there. So here, the web host that I picked is called 000webhost.com. It's just something that I searched and found, and it is actually pretty good. The UI builder app that you created will work on any web server. So it can be this one or whatever really you found that provides a web server that can just serve files, that'll work. So in here, there is a file manager, and this is the file manager. And the way this 000 web host works is there is a directory called public HTML, and this is where the content needs to be uploaded to. So what I will do is I will go to my app and I will select everything that I want to upload and just drag it out here. Okay, and it will provide a summary of everything that I'm uploading, including the directories. Click upload and it just starts working, uploading everything to that specific directory. So now everything has been uploaded. So then the next thing that I can do is I can just run it from that web host. And as you can see, here's my UI builder application where all the content was loaded up from that web host, but it still communicates with Backendless for the backend. So all the data does come from Backendless, but the files are being loaded from the web host. And then if you need to assign a domain name, you can definitely do this. I actually did assign a domain name for this account. And then what I will do is demo.endl.es. It's a domain that I have. And as you can see, it loads it up. So then it's just a matter of assigning a certificate and it will work. So, but this is meant to demonstrate that you can take your UI builder application, regardless of how complex it is, and move it out of Backendless, and by doing so, you will save on all those API requests that come from fetching files, because at this point, all the files are being loaded from that web host. I hope that you find this useful. Thank you for watching, and as always, happy coding with Backendless.